What's going on, everyone? This is iTalk News here, and in today's video, we have a brand new video. So today, I just wanted to discuss three things that I think that you guys will like to hear about in the Fortnite community. So first things first is that Fortnite has just announced that they are getting a special retail bundle called the Deep Freeze Set. Now, there's not much else that we know about this. All we know about this whole thing is that it's coming out November 13th. It's a few things. It's the Frostbite outfit, which looks like this. I'll put it on the screen right here. The Cold Front Glider, the Chill Axe Pickaxe, the Freezing Point Back Bling, and 1,000 V-Bucks. All for the low, low price of $30. Kind of a decent amount of money, honestly, but it's not terrible if you really think about it. Like, if the outfit is a epic or legendary, that would be like 15 to 20 bucks. Then the pickaxe is probably like $8. And then you get 1,000 free V-Bucks. It might actually be a decent deal. It all depends on how you feel about the skin, how you feel about the set, whatever. But in my opinion, I think it looks really cool. It gives me that Alpine Ace kind of vibe, and it also kind of looks like Raptor, which is pretty ridiculous that I don't like the Raptor skin. But when you put some snow goggles on them and, you know, you make them a different color scheme, I like it. It's weird. I don't know. So I do really like it. I will be getting it as soon as it comes out. It will be available for Nintendo Switch, PS4, PS4 Pro, and the Xbox One for $30, like I said. And it'll be available to download digitally in the in-game store and first-party digital marketplaces. So I'm not 100% sure if you can get this on your PC account. I don't know if you can, like, buy it and then put a code in for the PC, or you have to do it through, like, the PS4 and then do it that way like they did with the Royal Bomber skin. I'm not entirely sure. I will cover that more when we get news of it. Second thing I wanted to talk about is that the Support a Creator event starts this week. I made a video early today about how Drifter made a YouTube video about how he thinks that this event could be clickbaited to death. Kind of like how gifting was, when gifting wasn't even out, still not out. People would clickbait the hell out of it. Now with the Support a Creator event, he was worried, and myself included, that people were going to clickbait it, saying, oh, if you buy this much amount of V-Bucks with my name on it, then I'll give you the Skull Trooper or something like that. Like, it's really bizarre, but I think people would fall for it, which is really sad. And I don't know much else about it, but I made a video about it. So if you would like to watch it, I'll leave a link down in the description, and I'll put a card right here for you. So Happy Power did not get accepted into the Support a Creator event. I honestly don't know why. I'm assuming it's because he did leaks, and not that he did leaks, but he actually did leaks himself. And that's a no-no for Epic Games. They don't want you going into their game files or anything like that. Like, he's a legit leaker. So that's probably why he wasn't allowed in. And he shared his thoughts about this on Twitter, and he said, if it's to support creators, I feel like Epic should give creators more rather than fans spending $500 to only give their favorite creator $25 lmao. Hashtag Epic scam. He ended up deleting this tweet. And I made a response saying, you're only calling it a scam because they denied you. This helps out small creators. They could literally give people nothing in return, but they are nice enough to give people money for buying V-Bucks. It's a 5% commission. You're sponsored. You should know how this works. And it's true. Once again, if it was legit, if Happy Power got accepted, he would not be calling it a scam. He's only calling it a scam because he broke game rules. He went into the game files. You're literally not allowed to promote third-party apps that give free V-Bucks, and you're not allowed to leak stuff from the game. You're not supposed to be doing the initial leaks. If I cover the leaks, I'm not the one that dug up the game files. It's people like Happy Power, everyone else that does it. So I don't know. And the way he acted about it was kind of shitty, in my opinion. The fact that he called it a scam just because he didn't get into it, I don't get it. I even did, like, hashtag stay happy, more like hashtag stay salty, because, man, it seemed like he was salty where he was coming from. And it's just a little ridiculous to me that he would stoop so low as to call Epic Games a scam because he didn't get accepted. It just seems a little ridiculous. But yeah, he deleted both tweets about it, so I don't know what else to say about it. The last thing I want to talk about is that we are getting the quad rocket launcher, most likely either Wednesday or Thursday. We'll find out later today, I'm assuming, because that's when they usually announce it. But with the introduction of the quad launcher, and we still don't have any word on Disco Domination, I thought it'd be a cool idea to share some ideas that the community has thought of in terms of limited time modes. So from JDragon978, he made up this one limited time mode, and he called it the Flash Flood limited time mode, and it says, water outside the island will start to rise immediately when game starts. The island will start to flood after 5 minutes. You die if you touch the water. Jetpacks added in this mode. Water keeps rising until there is a winner. Easier to get materials. Grapplers, launch pads, and bouncers are easy to find in this mode. I think this is a great idea. However, I wouldn't make it so you die if you touch the water. I think it's more like maybe if your head is completely submerged under the water, then maybe you die. Someone even mentioned maybe making it lava, which once again, I think that'd be pretty cool. But yeah, I just thought that would be a really cool concept to share with you. This is from JDragon978 on Reddit. I will leave a link to him down in the description. And then the other one I saw, this was months ago, but someone had recommended we have a lights out limited time mode where everything is just a lot darker. Once again, I think that would be super cool. And then also, I just wanted to quickly mention, someone asked if we could get an offline mode where it's you against 99 different bots. I think that would be really cool too. I don't know how they'd be able to program bots for Fortnite, but I think they could totally do it, and I think it's a really cool idea. And that comes from Parker C. Burton. I will once again leave a link in the description for him as well. And for the limited time mode lights out, that was from Jacob Badgian, I believe it's how it said. I'll leave a link to his post down in the description as well. And that's it, guys. Also, really quickly before I end the video, I just wanted to let you know, yes, I did get accepted into the Support a Creator event. My tag name is ITalkFortnite, all one word, no spaces. So if you want to support me whenever it comes out, because it is coming out this week, you're more than welcome to do that. I'm not going to beg for your support, but if you want to support me, you're more than welcome to do that. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed, let me know with a like. I will not beg for it. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Turn on the bell just to get all my latest uploads. Comment down below. What are your thoughts about everything? Are you excited for the Support a Creator event? What do you think about the Deep Freeze bundle? What do you think about these limited time mode options? Let me know. Follow me on Twitter at ITalkFortnite and join the Discord. Have a good one, guys. See ya.